Thank you, Chair. Brothers and sisters, fellow delegates, let me in the outset, as we have completed 100 years of the ILO centenary and the future of work, which yesterday was well deliberated by Brother Philip Keening, rather than reiterating the similar, I would just endorse him in one way which says of the Philadelphia Declaration, poverty anywhere constitutes danger to prosperity everywhere. And labor is not a commodity, and a signal has been given to the entrepreneur that labor is also not a commodity, but it is your capital as well. Now, the ILO institution itself has a greater responsibility to shoulder for the future of work initiatives, and for which definitely our department, ACTRAC, has to play a very important role and to encounter a very huge responsibility. Previously, that I praise Sister Maria Alina and ACTRAC under her leadership. It is doing well in many parts of the world. South Asia, where they were supporting also the SARTEC initiative and activities, which is highly commendable. I think ILO as an institution has to go ahead with this, and that is the very important huge agenda before us for next time to come. Now I come to the thematic paper which has been presented by Brother Yoshoya Yashida and ITUC-AP, this regional conference. Importantly, the areas are very important: peace, democracy, and rights, global shifts, equality. But I would like to focus only because of the time frame, just on regulating economic power, in which multinationals has an important component in this conference document. Global income. Now, when the global business is controlled by these multinational corporations, they are not less. As the report indicates, 63,000 with their 700,000 FDAs. 90% of these multinationals, they come originally from the OECD countries. 94% of their workforce is in the global supply chains. And the similar way where global supply chain names comes, then poverty wages and slavery wages is one of their components. For us, in Pakistan also, Chinese multinationals, those they have their role, and physically and technically government has given them this incentive where there would not be any labor laws applicable, not through legislation, but in practice. We have to see it in the such situation where how this can be remedied. And this thematic paper, actions plan with OECD. And I am very thankful for Brother Joya Yachida. He already mentioned about Maruti Suzuki, in which there are some action plans already. The other one is economic integration, Asian Development Bank, in which it has to take quite well, where the interaction is needed to have that how better framework agreement it comes in the business on 10 action plan for UN guiding principle for business and engagement with FTAs. Six papers on employment and labor market policies. That is 6-point agenda. That is very encouraging, on which three campaigns areas are very important to accomplish. Which the last point is regarding decent work and decent wages, global production and wage level, in which we have seen that how living wage and poverty wage to encompass living wage, non-standard form of work, and there are five such thematic areas which action plan has been designed by ITUC-AP, and that is encouraging. Well, more particularly, let me see as how national minimum wage, how labor respect for universal guarantee for labor rights under minimum wage internationally, and how to make it universal guarantee for the labor rights under which the minimum wage has to be for the workers, and more particularly on the global supply chain. Particularly when we see about these global supply chain at the end, global supply chain, these multinationals contribute less towards the development of the country, but much more for the exploitation of its people, and usually means higher profits for few, low standard for most. It is right conscience for those who are negating all those human values, because he who pay less to his worker not only commit a sin that it deprives its poor worker from their right to enjoy life, but also strikes for the very basis of prosperity. Because all production or distribution effort is made for consumer, shrinks the market, and consequently the production and distribution itself. A national and international rethinking is therefore necessary to determine the extent to which workers in the developing nations has to sacrifice basic human rights, rights of unionism, and of collective bargaining through such trans-economic gains they follow by way of attracting any foreign investment without fixing the priority of the quality of life of workers. Therefore, Honorable Chair, a higher question stares us on our own face. Do we allow ourselves to emerge as a supplier of cheap labor or a merchant of human misery? Or do we compel each and everyone to insist upon the certain standards? Those are the standards very well defined in the action plan of the ITUC-AP document. Thank you very much.